What at the beginning of your career do you wish you had known, or do you wish you hadn't believed?
I wish I had known that I had the opportunity to take risks and screw up and come back and climb the hill again and keep going, and didn't view every step in my career as so precious.
I wish I knew when I founded my company almost 9 years ago that it was actually a huge advantage to be a young woman. We went and pitched VCs at the beginning, and they were all old men. And they would ask us questions and say, well, I'm going to have to ask my daughter about that. If I'd known earlier to embrace my femininity, I could have gotten over some hurdles earlier.
You're often just taught to just like put your head down, don't speak up, and just like do great work. No boss is going to sit you down and necessarily, you know, be the owner of your own career. You have to take ownership, and you really can make change, and it really does start in a small way.
It's okay to take maternity leave. And I didn't. I took like 2 months. It was crazy. And in retrospect, I think learning to manage yourself and not take on too much responsibility, I think as women, and I'm wary of generalizations, we're capable and we like doing things and getting it done and being responsible. But I think sharing that responsibility and being very collaborative about it and open to the idea that other people can help you is also empowering.
So I want to know if there is, you know, one concrete change that each of you would make that you think would really help women in work.
If a professional happens to be a parent and in their relationship is the primary parent, whether they're single, married, whatever that is, support that choice and understand that you can be a professional and a parent and a friend and a sister, and it doesn't make you a worse professional. So I think avoiding that discrimination and creating more flexible and supportive workplace policies for parents in particular.
I think that women carry so much guilt in their lives. Am I being a good mom? Am I doing well at my job? Did I take care of my mother's birthday? You know, and berating ourselves for, you know, we need to work harder and do more and be better. And so I always try to tell women, like, you're doing enough.
I think I've seen it at WPP with our fellowship program. They get a mentor system. You get two mentors within the business who you can go and check your opinion against. And I think as a junior or a young executive, being able to triangulate that kind of advice is invaluable, male or female. And I think while we're still combating the numbers game and getting enough women into business, even the male-female mentorship route is really valuable. I think we've got to tap into that and take advantage of it as young executives.
Do you feel you're successful?
There's actually been psychological studies done about young women or any women who say, I'm a success. It makes people like you less. You need to say, I'm successful because my team is really great, and I'm successful because I got lucky, and I'm successful because I was in the right place at the right time. If you say, I'm successful because I'm awesome, and I'm smart, and I'm capable, and I work really hard, and I've accomplished my goals, and I'm driven, it makes you less likable. So I think we know that, and I think that that's something that we want to change. And so for fear of being unlikable, I'm going to say, yes, I feel successful because I'm smart, and I'm driven, and I work really hard, and I've set goals for myself, and I've accomplished them.
As leaders, we need to make people feel comfortable with sharing their full selves, and that means that we have to share failure, sadness, and breed an environment where people feel that that is acceptable and makes us all more connected and more effective.
Thanks for being here, and thanks to all of our panelists for their great insights.